Hey, how's it going, duty sulfurs? Have you ever been to the gas station and after filling up your gas tank, wonder just exactly how the gas nozzle knows to stop when your gas tank is full? Well, wonder no more, because today I'm gonna go full nerd on the whiteboard here and show you exactly how it works. All right, so when you're trying to gas up your car and you grab the nozzle and press up on the handle, you're basically pressing up on the main valve that's in the nozzle, opening up this orifice here, which allows for fuel to flow through the nozzle. All right, as you can see, here's where the main valve is inside the nozzle. And at the same time, you're pressing down on a second valve, which is your fuel shutoff valve. And this valve has a vacuum operated diaphragm on top of it. And the second valve is usually further down in this area right here inside the nozzle. So yeah, when you press up on the handle, you're pressing this one up and the other one down. Again, just to show it to you on the whiteboard, this valve goes up with the handle, and since they're connected, it pulls down on the second valve. And once you get fuel to flow through the nozzle, here comes the magic. The nozzle is designed to make sure the fuel is forced through a small opening or orifice. Because when you force fuel through a small opening, you build up an area of high pressure before the opening and an area of low pressure after the opening. And as a result, the fuel starts flowing a lot faster after the orifice into the area of low pressure we have now. And this is what's called a Venturi effect. And that orifice is usually either a part of the main valve or part of the main body of the nozzle further in. And what happens next is, as gas starts flowing at a high speed here, it's gonna pull a vacuum and it's gonna actually start pulling air through a hole at the tip of the nozzle here. And here's the hole we're talking about. As you can see, it's at the tip of the nozzle, and this is where the air gets sucked in to the nozzle. And that air is gonna travel through this tube all the way over the diaphragm of your gas shutoff valve and then simply mix with the gas. And here you can kind of make out the tube that starts at the hole at the tip of the nozzle and goes all the way inside the nozzle. So as you're gassing up and your tank gets full, the gas that comes up through your filler pipe is gonna block off the flow of air that's going through this tube. And then the gas that's traveling through here and pulling a vacuum on this circuit is not gonna pull in air, so instead it pulls up on this diaphragm. And as the diaphragm moves up on this side, it pulls down on the handle, releasing the main valve, blocking off the flow of fuel through the nozzle. And that's all there is to it. Pretty complicated and interesting if you ask me. But have you ever had this happen?
Uh-oh, what's going on here? My tank isn't even close to full.
Yep, if you drive cars long enough, that's bound to happen to you. And that's usually a sign of a problem with your EVAP system. And if you want to learn how you can fix that, I recommend you click and watch this video up top. I'll also put a link to it in the description box. But before you go, do me a favor and share this video. Also, if you like, join me on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter, of which I'll put links in the description box down below. And if you want to see more videos like this, make sure you subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time.